Good afternoon, guys. Day three of putting the shed together. After confidently believing the weather report with it saying that it wasn't going to rain last night, it clearly has last night. Now that means the roof is wet. It shows how waterproof the ivy is over there, but it also means that this is wet. Like, slight problem with that. Like, I know the SDF, this is meant to deal with it, and is, like, I see everyone be like, oh, it's structural. But this stuff here, I think, is my downfall at the moment. Like, it is solid. It's not relenting. Let me hit the middle. It's dry. I mean, like, I think it's only come from, you can see a bit there. Well, that's dry. That's from the previous line of stuff there. But if I hit it, like, it's still, I feel it's still solid. I think that means that I'm gonna have to wait until it dries to get the membrane and then the, like, cover over it, as the waterproof cover over it as well. And then maybe, it is in the harder cover. I need to, I'll find out what it's called and just maybe to try some editing, put that here. But warm that up at the radiator, because then it apparently rolls easier. So I'll give myself the best chance I can. You can definitely see how limited I am for space here. The idea right now, because it's Monday now, is to, oh wow, I missed a few. Missed screws on the OSB. Oh well. Is get a tarp over the top to make it waterproof at least. And then after having a go with my hammer drill, which is a great tool, but it is no match for this concrete. I mentioned at work that I did some Googling and I was like, oh, I need something called an SDS drill. And then one of my co-workers was just like, why, I've just turned up with one today. Which, for a design agency who builds websites, it is definitely a unique bring to work. So I have now got myself an SDS drill, currently on hammer because I was playing with it, but got myself a 6mm masonry drill bit, which is long enough for it. I'm gonna give it a go, hopefully sink a concrete screw. Because my previous attempts, like, the brick's fine. My hammer drill can do brick brilliantly. But the concrete, this was a 100mm concrete screw, and this was actually a 75mm concrete screw. I will probably keep these corner blocks in, as I'm going to be cladding it on the outside, and not really the inside, because it's not going to be insulated at all. If I sink one here, and then go from there, see how it goes, but hopefully that should be able to withstand it. It's scheduled to rain for 2 days now. If the roof dries up, then I can do something about it. If the roof doesn't dry up under the tarp, at the current rate forecast, it's not set to be dry until a week after that. I'm not looking the best on it, but looking forward to giving it a challenge. So let's get a tarp on, nail that on, and go from there. Happy with that. Just a few nails in. Luckily my tarp has eyelets in it, and on the top there's an overhang, so I don't have to get it flush. Let's try and tackle these now. Well,
That melted it,
and that is definitely deep enough.
All right, let's give that a go.
Stand on it. I tell you what, the light is amazing on this. What's the worst that can happen?
Ooh, wow, okay, that has sunk it. That is not coming out.
Right, well, I think it's time to do the rest.
I think I will pilot hole them. As well as I've got three drills, I might as well. Well, I found out how deep it is. I am about 2 inches away from the edge, so I know I haven't blown out. Yep, definitely found the bottom of the concrete.
Wow, though, it sunk them. Like, it was able to get all of these. Like, there was no tomorrow. I haven't bothered doing any of this. I know my hammer drill does this fine, so I don't feel there's any need at the moment. That is not going anywhere. That's already got 5 bolts in it. Like, I feel it's just a bit redundant. I mean, like, I'll put one maybe there at the other end, but...
What a difference that made. Tarp on, keep it dry. Now it's not going anywhere in any storm which the roof catches. Just a short one, but up until the sun, that's it. Hope you're enjoying following along, and I'll catch you in the next one.